Alright, what's up guys? This is Daniel with Midnight Movie Trash, and this episode, it's another Misty Monday. And being the first Monday of the month, we're going to review Sinful, starring Misty Mundane, you know, Aaron Brown, as well as Erica Smith and Ron Smith. Directed by Tony Marsigliano. I'm butchering his name, I know, apologize. From research, it began filming in 2003, and it had a few bumps in the road. Losing a place where they were gonna film, which from the DVD special features interview with Misty, looked like a homeless camp, you know, an abandoned house, trashed to all hell, and you know, they lost that place, which on online researching found out that I believe they went to Jim's house, who is Ron Smith, and they wind up doing the scenes there, as well as, you know, the prison scene was filmed in a bathroom from what I read. But yeah, and it is I guess you would call it a erotic drama film, being the fact that Lilith, Misty Mundane's character, is a very unhappy wife, sexually frustrated, unable to conceive a child due to health reasons, and they're on their fourth attempt, and things aren't looking good, and it drives Lilith into a descent into madness, where, you know, the young next door couple who has the perfect life in Lilith's eyes, which is played by Erica Smith, you know, Aisha, she has the loving husband, you know, the sex life that she wants. She's pregnant. So Lilith becomes obsessed with her life, and you know, the way I see it, it feels like she's got what I would say sympathy pains, where she's going through the motions of she's pregnant also, living vicariously through Aisha. And you know, there's a scene where she goes into the doctor and she's like, oh, I'm pregnant, and she even has morning sickness in the waiting room type deal, where she vomits and whatnot. And you know, it's she's in her heart of hearts pregnant, and the doctor was like, no, you're not, you know, you're barren. And you know, he grabs his head and shoves it in her crotch. He's like, look in there, there's a baby in there. So you start to see the slow descent into the madness, and it drives her insane, and you know, rightfully so, because she wants something, you know, that's hers, because everybody tells her to adopt, and that's just not what she wants. She wants something that she created. And you know, on top of her frustrating marriage life and a husband who's not working, and you know, I guess he can't get it up, because the movie starts out where she's yelling, fuck me, riding him, and he's just laying like a fucking rag doll there. It's like, really, bro? But you know, they have a dinner with Aisha and her husband, and it gets weird really quickly. You know, they're almost in a hippie mindset, to where that what's mine is yours and what's yours is mine, you know, adding to a, you know, their, that's what they, he believes, and she's, you know, like, I wouldn't say brainwashed, but you know, she's totally in love with this dude and having this child, and you know, they're all, she's saying that she's basically sexually attracted to Lilith and her husband, and the husband, you know, excuses himself and goes and brings the, not the aborted, but the miscarried fetus of one of their attempts. And I was like, what the hell? But yeah, that's the kind of movie this one is. But, you know, everything that could go wrong for Lilith goes wrong. You know, her work life is shit. She works helping others in, I guess, like a welfare situation type deal. And, you know, she has a gun there. And it comes to play that gun comes out when she fully descends into her madness. And, you know, the life, you know, she lives with, the relationship she lives with her mother is another one that adds to her descent. You know, her mom is a shit person type deal, and, you know, it leads to them, it leads you to believe that there was some kind of a inappropriate relations between the stepfather and Lilith. And there's even a scene where that takes place, and the mom takes Jim, her husband, to the bedroom. So yeah, it's a pretty fucked up scenario for Lilith. But, you know, there's a, I mean, it's a little bit of a drag in the film, you know, pacing and lengthwise and feel, but, you know, it's pretty dark and twisted for what it really is. And personally, I give this one a 6 out of 10. And I give it a 6 because Misty really nails the role of Lilith. And I personally believe that Aaron Brown, you know, Misty Monday, is a very underappreciated actress. From, you know, we know her as, like, you know, the queen of B movies with EI Cinema and all that label, but her, what I read was like 80 films she did under them, something like that. That's what the website said. You know, I'm sitting there like, I don't know. But, you know, the multitude of films she did there, she played every role you could possibly think of. And she always nailed it. And even to her current work, you know, more recent stuff she's done with Beelzebub and, you know, other stuff she has coming up, like Thrust. You know, she really is one hell of an actress. But Erica Smith, you know, is, you know, the girl next door. She has that vibe, that look, you know, as well as Misty. But this one, she really has real girl next door vibe. And, you know, her look and the way she portrayed Aisha with that girl next door vibe, as well as a bit of innocence in a way, it really comes out on screen. And they did an amazing job, the two of them. And, you know, I know Tony's worked with Misty in quite a few, as well as Erica also. You know, he does a great job in this one directing. You know, he also wrote the story, which, from, you know, online, checking online, it had a working title of Mine. And I could see why they would name it that, being how obsessed Lilith was with Daisy, the name of the baby that Aisha names. And the ending of the film, it's pretty twisted. And I would expect nothing less from a film like this. And I won't spoil the ending if you haven't seen it, but yeah, it's overall, you know, like I said, I give it a 6 out of 10. you know, dark, twisted film. You know, Aaron and Erica nail their roles. You know, it's one of the things that really added to the vibe of the creepiness of it is when Lilith is incarcerated or locked up or whatever. She builds a wire doll, and it is very creepy and unsettling. You know, this doll that she creates as her child. So yeah, you know, it's, if you haven't seen it, check it out. You know, to me it was a little drawn out, a little long, you know, but it sets up the vibe, sets up the feel, and you know, what would you do in Lilith's shoes? How would you react? Would you descend into the madness she did? You know, that's a question to ask, but you know, from what I've seen, this film was towards the end of Misty's run with EI Cinema and, you know, that whole label. And this was, I believe, 2 years into Erica's involvement with them. So I wouldn't say it's a changing of the guard type deal, because Misty was one of a kind. And the two don't really compare, because Misty's so unique and whatnot. But I know, I believe Erica's first film with them was A Bite Me. And from IMDb and the credits from the EI Cinema era, and that's with all those Chakarama, all those labels, this was towards, it says 2006 when it was released. So I believe 2007-ish was about the time that Misty, you know, leaves EI Cinema and all that stuff. But you know, let me know in the comments what you think of Sinful. You know, have you seen it? Did you enjoy it? You know, me personally, this is not one of my top Misty films. I think there's a bunch of other ones that are more enjoyable for me per se, but you know, it's still, you know, a classic Misty film. So with that being said, you know, please like, subscribe, comment, leave me suggestions of which films I should look into as far as Misty's films, and that includes anything she's done, not just the EI Cinema era. But I did pick up That 70s Girl this week, so that's going to be another one coming up for review. And I'm going to pick one randomly to do for July. And with that being said, till next time, see ya.